Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. We have already seen this in action, in fact, in the previous tutorial, and that wasn't meant to be, but it just happened to go that way. So in this tutorial, I just want to explain the fact that we could utilize the print built-in function as a Django diagnostic tool. It can be quite a handy tool to help us understand the type of data or to explore the data that we're working with. So back into the code where we left off from the previous tutorial, we saw that we started to utilize some of the built-in functions, the Python built-in functions here, to, in this case, to print data to the terminal. Now, I just wanted to expand that concept a little bit further. Notice that this print function here will print out data, will print out the values. And I just wanted to give you an idea that you could utilize this to explore the data that is being returned from a database potentially. Maybe you are trying to work with a specific set of data here and you're not entirely sure, or you can't quite follow the process. You could utilize the print function here to explore the data. So imagine this was data from a database. You perform some action. You weren't entirely sure exactly what data was being passed into it. We could use the print. Now, one thing we haven't necessarily spoken too much about because it's out of the scope of this course, but we have this request data. So this data here comes from, for example, in the browser, the user types in the domain name or the IP address. That's sent across. Now, this information is passed into the view because we might want to utilize this information for specific reasons before we then pass it back to then be sent to the correct user. So we might want to access that data for a particular reason. So let's go ahead and do that. So here I'm going to type in request. Let's go back to my homepage and refresh so we can action the code. And you can see this is the data that's being stored inside of this request here. And you notice that what's being returned here or stored in the request is the actual location of the URL. And that's fairly interesting. So you can see that we can utilize this ultimately as a diagnostic tool to help us understand the data that we're working with or to explore the data that we're not entirely sure exactly what we're using or whether it's actually returning the correct value. So although that might not be an exact science, and it's not always the case that we can utilize print, definitely at the start of your development process, do consider thinking about breaking things down, particularly if things aren't working correctly. Break the process or flow down into stages and use prints to help you guide yourself exactly where the process is working or incorrectly working.